Hello everyone, welcome to another video of TOSCA obstacle list. In this video we are going to cover the next problem 73588. So let's take a look at this. I'll click on go for it. Generate a random string and select in the combo box below. So if I click on this, a random text is getting generated which will keep changing. Obviously it is random, so if I click and then I have to click on this and select this. Okay, so basically whatever value is getting generated here is going to appear in the drop down as well. So if you see AW, this thing is there. Now again I'll click, so ZF should be here. Maybe let me search with that. ZF, yeah, ZF was there. Okay, okay, so if I select this and then I click on submit, then that is going to solve this automation problem. Okay, now let's quickly fire up our scan. So I'll go to my modules, I'll scan this. Three, four things which I need is, first is I need this particular link, generate random text. So I'll click on select on screen, I'll get this. I need this as well, so I'll select this. I need this, so I'll select this. I need to submit, so I'll click on this. Okay, now this is showing as not found. Let me see if I select this. Okay, so we are good here. Now here we see that it is taking ID and A, we are good, this is unique. Random text, ID and tag, so it is not taking the value, good. So this is unique, select link is unique, submit is unique, so we are good here. I will quickly save this module with the obstacle number, so I'll put obstacle hash 73588. And I'll close this. So basically this number keeps changing and dynamically I have to select it from the drop down. Let's see how we'll do that. So let me drag and drop this to my test cases and I'll just rename this test case with the obstacle number and let's get started. So first thing is click on generate random text, so I can pass a X or a click here. After that this number is going to get generated, which we have to pass in select link. So let's buffer this. I can click select buffer here and it is by default taking this particular buffer name, so let's go with that. I will just copy this because we have to pass this buffer in the select link. Now here you can input and here you can pass this buffer. So I'll put curly brackets B square brackets and I'll put the buffer name and I'll close this. Once we have selected that, then we have to click on submit. So I'll pass X here. We'll see if any wait issue happens in this, so we'll handle it accordingly. Let's run this and see if it works. So it should first click on generate random text, whatever value is getting generated that should be passed into the drop down. Okay, so this worked perfectly fine. It first clicked on this, it happened very fast, but it clicked on this, it generated a different value and that value was selected in this and then the submit was clicked. So we have successfully finished our 73588 automation problem. See you in the next video in which I am going to cover other obstacles. Thank you very much. In case you like the content, do like, share, and subscribe.